low set in his
right.
neck.
Right. Yeah, but he tends to get low.
To get creative sometimes. It's easier. It's a little easier if you have a surf signal because you can cut adjust it.
Hello.
I'm just gonna.
Oh no! I thought maybe you're out running around here with the pockets.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I keep the side ready.
Yeah. And no, the dry suit.
First horse was a quarter horse that I had for the time he was 9 until he was 34.
Aww.
And we started out at Pony Club doing eventing. And we did open jumpers, preliminary eventing, and he did his first pre-stage George dressage test when he was 21 years old.
Aww.
He looked very much like him as if he was a chestnut with four white socks.
See, we can do it, Sonny.
And he had started his career as a barrel racer and then gone to the racetrack because he was AQHA bred but appendix registered. And they put him on the track and he ran a little bit. And then he ponied horses on the track. And then he did some more barrel racing. And then I got him.
He was the do-everything horse.
He was crazy too. Oh my God, he was nuts. When I first got him, he was crazy. He wasn't really crazy, but I think because his life had been a little crazy always. But he was always very, very excited about the jumps. He could jump the moon. He could jump, I think I jumped almost 6 foot of moon. I just am improvising because I want my side reins to come out a little higher on him because he's a little low set. And so I just did that too.
So it was the same on both sides.
Yeah, and I will adjust the length of him. Right. So I said before,
do you want that one that come over there?
I always start horses I don't know without side reins, so that I get a feel for like how they're going to react, and I don't risk them standing up and flipping themselves over because they've never felt a side rein before. I also like to watch the horses just move normally without anything on them, so I can kind of evaluate their soundness and their way of going. Yeah, but she's weird. I don't like her already. She has ideas. I've got it just the way I like it right now. There's no need to change.
Speakers aren't working.
The speaker is not. It was.
I know it was, but now it's not.
The speaker might die. There's two there.
It lights, but then it goes away.
Yeah, I don't know which one she has hooked up.
It died about this time yesterday, too.
It was, yeah.
There we go.
you want me to read it? Okay, I'll sit down.
So one of the things Kalei said is she wanted to kind of learn how to do this and wanted to watch it. And I'm gonna have her come in and do a little once I get him going along. She also told me yesterday that he can get a little heavy in her hands and harder downhill and stuff. And so again, we talked a little bit before about the how you can
why are you doing the outside rain suit?
Because I want to get there. I wanted him to soften through the flexion there, which is going to change how he uses the roof. We'll see if that happens. Here, good boy. And I also want to teach him to respond to that, or keep him at that time, the outside flexion. He would rather canter and give it to me than try to make it suck it up. So basically, and also one of the things I want to get from him is to open up his trot a little bit. So the fact that he wants to canter all the time means he'd rather canter than take a bigger step as a trot. Okay, so for her to have medium trot, what she would like to create, and a little bit of tension. So the starting him through the outside rein was to get his knee to a place where I could access more trueness in his body. But there it changed his shape now. Can you see that?
Mm-hmm.
Like he's in a shorter shape than he was, and he's in a bigger trot. So he still wants to just reach out a little bit in his neck and not pull up as well as I try to work him to. Good boy. So there's some work on this for a minute. There.
Thank you.
come back and tell him to.
Okay.
He's soothing. Don't try to stop it or correct it. He'll stop doing it. It'll just go away when he's comfortable with it. It's just he feels a little too much confinement. And that's the danger with doing this stuff. And it's the same thing with lunging the side rings. If you put things on to a point of effectiveness, you might run up against those problems. That's pretty normal. Okay, I'll just let it fall to the ground. Is there something over there?
seems worried.
And
to allows the ride you to a little shorter contact, and you have to get rounder and a little lighter to that shorter contact. And a little more activated from behind. That's right. If he does any jigs, don't worry about it, Kelly. Just wait him out and then soften him when he walks. And soften his jaw a little bit while he's doing that. So you say you can use that jiggy energy, but you have to close your body and get softer to me while you do it. Then he won't want to do it as much. That's good. Good. And then go up to a sitting trot when you're ready. Look forward. One more trot. Come. A little more stroke. Think of the trot I just had on the lines. Get a little tap with the whip. There you go. There you go. That's nice. Not any longer than that. So keep thinking, I want to get this feeling, then I want to shorten my reins an inch and have the same feeling with him, just a little rounder and a little higher. So not lower rounder, but a little higher in his neck. Good. 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 And straight ahead. Ask him to flex his pole to the right as you're going down the long side. Move the bit on the right side until you feel his nose come in and his jaw soften. That's right. Flexion at the pole means that the head, the whole horse flexes inward and to the side slightly. And flexing at the pole again, you want to see his right eyeball. There you go. Good. Now flexing to the left. So you're just seeing what your access is. Stay straight in your body, don't turn a little bit to the side, and ride a little more trot. Sit a little bigger trot, tell him he has to trot more. There you go. So the trot he had on the long lines was another layer forward, and he tracked up behind. So we need to let him trot a little bit bigger. A little bigger. Yeah, a little kick from behind. So come on, trot up to my reins like that. Yeah, good. Good. Good, like that. And really absorb that through your seat. I know it gets a little harder to sit, but you're really capable of that. So breathe out with your shoulders down a little bit and really move through your pelvis and say, I'm going to follow him out. Good. That's good. Down the next long side shoulder. And if you feel him make himself an inch longer, remind him not to. Say, I don't want longer horse. I want a shorter horse with more energy behind the saddle. Shorter horse with more energy behind me. Good job. And shoulder in. Good. Elbow in on the right. Good. Good. Down the next quarter line, shoulder in. So turn away from the wall. A little more trot. Push once from behind, sit a bigger trot. There, good. Slightly shorter right rein. Keep your left leg behind the girth, Kelly. You want the left leg to be helping the left hind push forward. And then in the shoulder in, we want to take that brace away from him. Yes, yes. Good. A little more trot. There, good. Giving in between shoulder reins. Hands a little forward with the shoulder reins. You're not trying to provide more contact when you shorten the reins. You're just trying to tell him that he gets to stay short in front of you, but he doesn't get to get long in front of you. A little more bending in the corner. Good. You want to see that right eyeball. That's good. See the right eyeball. Keep shoulder in. Keep your left leg behind the girth. Steady behind the girth. Make him rounder to your left rein. Just a little left turn. Yes. 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 Good. 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 Forward. One more trot. Sit, sit, sit. Punches in down the next long side. When you straighten from the shoulder in, don't, you're going into a corner. Don't take the flexion away. Okay?
Yeah.
Yeah, keep your right leg on. Keep your right leg on. Push with the left leg. Keep the right leg on. Push with the left leg. Little kick. So get your haunches off my left leg. So I would tap him with the whip there. And tell him, you need to move your butt. Round. On the bit. Good. Bending. Put your right leg on his girt, on the, at the girth. Left leg active. And then touch him with the whip and say, I need you to move your hind leg. Yes. Good boy. That's right. That's right. Then find a way to soften in front and keep coming forward. Right. Chop, chop, chop. Chop, chop, chop. I know. Haunches in is so hard. Good. And go out. Good. Rounder. Trotting, bigger trot. Swing through your hips. Really move through your seat for him. Yes, yes. Good, and hunches in again. We'll keep the trot going. So you keep sitting the trot. Yeah, that's right. Sit the trot, sit the trot, sit the trot. Good, and go straight. Good job. And now really forward in the trot, but keep the reins short and light. So your hands are forward, and you make little tiny quick half halts and gives so that you don't let him build in the contact. That's good.
Really good. Keep your right leg a little more back under you. Hip change rein. Good. Rounder. Rounder. Don't let him get off the bridle. Confront that a little. So, you know. Yeah. There you go. Good. Good. Bending. Trotting. Sit the trot a little bigger. You sit a bigger rhythm, he'll trot a little bigger rhythm. Good. Good. So we want to get the hind legs till they really reach up and trot from behind. That's good. A little lower neck. Slightly lower neck. Yeah, there. And give. And give. Good. Shoulder in down the next quarter line. That's good, Kelly. Good. Rounder. Feel him in front. Talk to him a little bit off my left leg. Keep your right leg behind the girth. You're still bending the horse between two legs. Good. Make it a little rounder in the shoulder in. You need a little more left leg, right rein connection. So the left leg needs to push him out a little more and a little tap with the whip so he hears your leg a little more. And then the outside leg stays back for the bend and your inside leg gets a little more flexion. Good. Elbows bent. Good. Rounder. Just a tad bit there. Now send him forward in that roundness. Think a bigger trot. Think a bigger trot. Think a bigger trot. Yes. Doesn't matter. Bring him back to trot. Nope. Doesn't matter. Now think bigger trot again. Shoulder in. Yeah. Right leg behind the girth. Rounder to your right rein. Move the bit a little aggressively on the right side of his mouth. Yeah, have that little confrontation. It's okay. It's okay. Yeah, there you go. Now give. Now give. Good. And forward. Good. Good. And hunches in. You okay? Okay, good. And hunches in. Make him rounder. Now bump, bump right leg. Then trot, trot, trot. Don't pull more on the left rein. You can soften him down, but don't let your left hand pull back. Good. Good job. There you go. Now trot forward across the short side because we need to keep the trot a little bit or bigger. If you need it, put your whip in your left. That's good. And your whip in your left hand. Good. And circle first. Circle first because you're not on the bit where we need to be. Yeah. So get around again. Good boy. Forward. Lower neck slightly. One more inch through his neck and rounder. There. Now give. Good. Yes. That trot. Good job. And now haunches in. Try not to complicate the aid. Just put your outside leg on from there. Yes. Yes. Yes, and go straight. If you lose trot in the lateral stuff, go short distances and then forward, and then short distance and forward.
Okay.
That was good. One more trot. Outside rein kind of bit. Good. Little rounder, playful rein, and then give. So you can make the contact and go straight this time. Make the contact a little lighter. That's a good trot. That's a good trot. Shoulders back, sit through your hips even more. Pretend he's a giant warm blood and he's got the biggest trot you've ever had to sit and sit it like it's that. And then if you get exhausted, there you go. And if you get exhausted, take a break, okay? Good, yeah, sit a big trot. Like he's a big swinging warm blood. Yes, look at that, super. Super, don't let the rein get longer. Don't let his neck get longer in front of you. You want that big swinging trot with the closed rein. One more. Big swinging trot, you think, sit the trot you want. Sit the trot in your mind's eye. Robert Dover was on us all. Pretend you're at the Olympics and you're sitting the biggest extended trot of your life. that's really good. That's really good. And walk and pet him and make a big fuss over and give him a break. How does that feel? Yeah, that, yeah, hard. Well, it's a bigger, more of a trot for you to sit, but you can do it. So sometimes when we're not used to that, we're like, whoa.
I feel like
it used to be that I could never even give him that good.
Flatten out, get really long.
And
yeah, yeah, yeah. He'll do it, yeah, definitely. And then you just have to sit and say, I'm going with this. That was really good. But that, if you watch when you see the video, you can see that that's a little different shape, and that's more what you need for your second level and working into third level frame. So, and that needs to keep, like, going a little further as you go along. Like, he can still come, not up hollow, but up a little bit more and arc a little bit more.
Well, I thought it was interesting that I had to let him come down this time.
Yes, a little bit, yeah, because he got a little too high in his neck and a little too tight. But the fact that he wants to go up a little is different.
Yeah.
I want you to canter a little in a
okay.
second. Sorry, I'm not quite done. Sorry, buddy. You have to do that in the gym. A little more active walk. Get a walk for a 7 all the time. Increases range of motion. You know, the thing is when we're riding a horse like him, who's adorable and cute, like our lean horse. They're super nice horses, but they're not big, moving, crazy, suspended, giant, warm blood movers. But we can maximize their movement potential by helping them reach a little bit bigger range of motion. That's what the point of sort of the long riding was with him, was to get him to find a little different frame and connection to the bit, and then to be able to expand his little body a little bit more, okay? Okay, take him up again. Shorter reins, good, that's enough, good, and trot, and then canter on the short side, and trot with the same intent. Now sit big trot, sit big trot, trot, because we have got to get this to a medium trot too, which is going to do after we canter a little bit. Canter when you're ready, it's okay, good. Now find that shape in the canter, get him a little looser through his pole, find that same shape in the canter, circle here a little bit. Yeah, that's right. Move a bit a little in here. Don't hold him in the canter. Get him to carry himself a little bit more. Shoulders back. There you go. Neck down a little on the right rein. Use your outside rein a little mobile. There. You want to get this feeling that he doesn't land on the rein and on his forelegs as much. He lands a little more on his hind legs. And now it's still rounder. You can do it. Think of the shape. Look in the mirror at the shape he's in. Think of the shape he was in on the long lines and think, I can make that shape happen, but I have to get in there and invade his space a little bit more. Not too much bend in the neck. Not too much more neck to the left. That's the girl. Elbows bent a little. Sit a little deeper. Let your seat be more part of his back than the canter. There you go. Good. One more round, one more piece to him to put the nose in a little bit. Flex with the pole a little more, and then I want you to give a little more. Yes. Flex at the pole a little more and give. Don't give with your body going forward. Soften him a little bit on the outside and almost make outside flexion one time. Now he's got to flex his pole to the right and give to you. A little more. Take it through it. Like on the long lines, you saw him brace on that, right? He did, and then he finally gave through it. There you go. And now back to the left. So make it a little more supple through that whole thing. Take your hands just a little bit wide for a moment. You're right. Got one, he's got to break through that little barrier that he wants to put up there. There. Now give. You feel that? And then just give for a stride. Don't give forever. And then recycle that, get that same reaction, and then give again. Yeah, and give again. Good. Yeah, and take it through again. Sit back. You want to push him a little with your seat and leg, just a little, and close the hand and say, yeah, that's right. And come back to trot. Forward to trot, rock. Good boy. Cut. Good. Now, yeah, now you can post, but keep him forward with a little more trot. Okay? Good. Now stay posting, trot. Shorten your reins 2 inches. Close him up a little bit. Soften his jaw. Don't let him be heavy on your hands. Then lighten your hand with short reins. Trot. Little tap with the left and say, no, you can go forward, boy. I know. Go across the diagonal and encourage a little bigger trot. Post bigger, post out of the tack more. There you go. Yes, good. That was a good effort. Did you feel him there? That was good. Now bending, you didn't bend to the right though. Yeah, there, good. He closed up nicely there. Little shorter reins again. And then if he gets heavier when you shorten the reins, really play with your fingers and wrist and then give. Play, give. Play, but short reins, give. Yes. A little more trot. A little more. You can do it. Post bigger. Don't just push with your legs. Get be in a little bigger post so he takes more step. Yeah, post a little quicker. There. Good job. Then come on the diagonal and ride another medium trot. And post a little bigger even still, like influence him with your whole body. That's good. That's good. Really good, Kelly. Not lower, because lower your reins are too long. So you say, you stay up here, round, good. Post big, rounder, rounder. Play with the reins, outside rein a little. There, yes, good job. Before I check your posting, good bunny, do that again on the diagonal. But he has to stay between those two reins and he can't make himself longer or lower or out. Yes, yes, yes. Good job. Yeah, then he starts to understand you want him to push up from his hind legs, right? Good job. Very nice. Sitting trot. Now sit big when you sit. Don't sit and slow him down. Yeah, good job. Good job. All right, buddy. Very well. Good. Yes. Good job. Bend him. Elbow bent on the right. Yeah, good job. Good answer. Good boy. And let him walk for a second. He's so honest, I don't want to let him have a good boy. So there you started to get something that I haven't seen him give you. And that was the push from behind that made the stride bigger but not get longer in front of you.
Yes.
Right? That was really good. I think we should probably stop there for today. You understand a little bit?
Yes.
So if you shorten your reins and you get a heavier feeling,